Nature has provided us with 450,000 plant species on our planet. We only use 30 of them to derive 85% of our nutritional input, and that is simply unsustainable. Welcome to African Crops for the Future. This is the series in which I investigate currently underutilized indigenous African plant species that I believe have great potential to be used by smallholder farmers as crops for the future, whether they're cultivated or wild harvested. I hope you guys are ready. This is going to be lots of fun. Let's dive straight in there. If you'd asked me 20 years ago where the ancestor of that big, beautiful, green, juicy watermelon comes from, I'm pretty sure I would not have told you that it's from the Kalahari Desert. But that actually, folks, is the truth. And this here that I'm holding in my hand is an ancestor, the original ancestor of the watermelon. We call it the Kalahari melon. In Botswana, they know it as the Tsama melon. Locally here in northwestern Zimbabwe, it's called Amajodo. How's it, guys? I'm Gus, the African plant hunter. This is the next episode in my ongoing series on underutilized plants that I believe have great potential as crops for smallholder farmers in Zimbabwe. And this is one of my very favorite. Citrullus lanatus is the botanical name. And you go to the watermelon, it has the exact same botanical name. It's the same species, but this is the original variety. Unlike the watermelon, it doesn't have that reddish flesh. This flesh is generally very pale. Unlike the watermelon, it doesn't taste particularly sweet. It is edible, and it is traditionally consumed in a number of ways. The flesh is taken out, it's dried, salted, and eaten like that. It's mixed fresh in with various porridges, all kinds of different ways to consume it. But what we're most interested in is not the actual watermelon or the Kalahari melon, but it's the seeds. So if you've ever chewed a watermelon and you've spat out the seeds, you know exactly what I'm talking about. And the seeds on this one are exactly the same. But what's interesting in them is the fatty acid composition in the oil in the seeds. So these seeds are rich in oil, very high in protein. This is eaten by all kinds of animals. The seed oil is traditionally consumed as an oil, used as a cooking oil. The way it's traditionally prepared is the seeds are dried, they're then pounded into a powder, the powder's boiled in water, and in that process of boiling, the oil separates out and it rises to the surface, and then you can skim it off and use it to cook with. The market opportunity relates to the cold pressed oil. So that involves taking the seeds and then putting them through a pressing machine at quite a low temperature and just letting the oil gently come out from the seeds. Once you've done that, you've got the seed cake left. The seed cake makes a wonderful stock feed, very high in protein, and the oil is used in the cosmetics industry. You can, of course, also use it in the food industry. But why in the cosmetics industry are they so excited about Kalahari melon seed oil? Well, there's a very simple reason. It's the fatty acid content, particularly one fatty acid called linoleic acid. And what that means is that this oil that comes from this melon is, although it's very intensely moisturizing, it also remains very dry when you apply it to the skin. So unlike a lot of oils, when you rub them into your skin, you get kind of quite a greasy feeling. With the Kalahari melon seed oil, when you stick it on your skin, it remains very dry. It's doing its job, it's moisturizing it, but it isn't giving you that, perhaps you don't like that unpleasant greasy feeling to the skin. So if you look around the world now in the cosmetics industry, there's a growing number of products that use this Kalahari melon seed oil. Not many other natural oils that have the exact same properties as this. And there are communities in Namibia, Botswana, and Zimbabwe who are currently already harvesting the seeds for pressing into oil. But at the moment, we're only doing a very small proportion of the potential. The global market for cold pressed oils is about $25 billion a year. So the percentage of that market that's taken up by Kalahari's melon seed oil is about 0.00000, you get the picture, 1%. So there's huge growth potential. It's got a fantastic story. Of course, these melons that grow wild throughout the bush in the Kalahari sands in the west of Zimbabwe and in the greater Kalahari region of Botswana, Namibia. People do sometimes cultivate them. It's very easy to cultivate, but they generally just tend to leave them there because they just grow naturally. And you can see I'm standing around. There's several of them on the ground just around me, just on the side of the road here. So this is one of the plants that I think has massive potential in the future. And I'm looking forward to seeing many rural communities potentially benefiting. Of course, this only occurs in very dry areas. People generally in very dry areas tend to be less well off. So it's very poor people who potentially benefit if this industry develops. So that's it, guys, my top tip for you today. The Kalahari melon, Citrullus lanatus, wild ancestor of the watermelon, and yet another one in my ongoing series on underutilized plants of commercial potential. If you've enjoyed that, there's plenty more on my YouTube channel and Facebook and Instagram. Just check out African Plant Hunter. I'm off to go catch some other underutilized plants. I hope you've enjoyed this. I will catch you later. Take it easy. Bye. Thank you.